Tonight, the Stig drives some very fast farm equipment, I hail a taxi, and finishing with something that I'm reliably informed is a bit of a fan favourite around here. I'm Chris Harris, and this is the Top Gear Horizon Special. Yes, the Stig, our very own UFO, unidentified fast object, the world's least obedient racing driver. Right then, the Lotus Elise, a 90s classic based on the age-old Roadster recipe. Two seats, engine in the middle, rear-wheel drive, not an ounce of fat. This is what driving is all about. You've got it. The trick with drifting is to not actually spin, but to almost spin for as long as possible. But this isn't just any Elise, it's a Sport 190, a tuned-up, stripped-out Elise for track days. Even the passenger seat is an optional extra. But who needs friends anyway? Friends are expensive and heavy. Yes! That's it! The Honourable Art of Drifting. Weighs well under 700 kilos and makes 190 horsepower from its 1.8 litre engine, which drifts to 8,000 RPM. Just listen to that! Lotus, it sticks to the famous philosophy of the man who founded the company, Colin Chapman. Simplify, then add lightness, he said. The Sport 190 also adds a full roll cage, just in case. Is, after all, one of the best-handling cars ever made. The Sport 190 is its hardcore cousin, a road-going racer you can drive to work and across fields, it turns out. But if it's true agricultural transport you're after, we have just the thing. Oh, a BMW 1M. Great car. Hang on, that's my BMW 1M. Seriously, not funny. Who gave Stig the keys? Just cleaned it. Now it's gonna smell of onions. Oh, the Stig. It's electronically restrained to 155 miles an hour, but it could definitely go quicker. Look at the smoke. Please leave me some tread for the drive home, Stiggy. Seriously, come on. Unattended. Am I the only one who remembers Budapest? Does 0 to 60 in 4.8 seconds. My 1M. Stig's way beyond that now. It's a BMW, so of course it's rear-wheel drive. 50-50 weight distribution too. It's a natural-born drifter. Watch? Not at all. 3 litre straight six, 335 horsepower, two turbos, and as much sideways action as you like. BMW's ever made this, born to be driven by me. Got to admit, that Stig does kind of suit it. Anyone else want to go? No? Don't say I didn't ask. Right. Back to the actual script now, if you don't mind. This is Top Gear's Tractor. It's a tractor, obviously, but with a 5.7 litre Chevy V8 making 500 horsepower. And here comes the Stig again. Farm Stig. Born in a barn, they say, weaned by pigs, can plough a field in under 6 seconds. There's a speed camera on the M68. Rumour has it, it only flashes above 87.2 miles an hour. Our Tractor has been officially clocked at 87.2 miles an hour, making it the world's fastest tractor. But I reckon it'll go even faster. Nobody needs to get the harvest in that quickly. Right, here comes the speed camera. Hope they put some film in it. Have you ever seen anything like it? That's a new tractor speed record and some impressively fast farming. If you want to spread slurry in a hurry, you know what you need. Now, though, it's time to hail a ride in something completely different. called a cab earlier. Local company, Aisha's Taxis. Excellent service. Got me here in no time. Unsurprising, really. I mean, look at what turned up. Hands down, the quickest cab I've ever been in. Which got me thinking, how fast could this thing actually go? So I had a word with Aisha, asked if we could borrow her cab for a trip to the seaside. To Bamborough Beach, in fact, where we could stretch the taxi's legs a bit. Although, I might have forgotten to tell her who'd be driving. You've guessed it, the cabbie who'll always get you to your destination very early, but probably won't be anywhere near where you asked to go. Holding adrift is a delicate balance of throttle, steering and shouting. Those tyres must be worn now. Surprised less than in one piece, to be honest. Now that's what I call a cab. No clattery diesel engine here. This has a V12 with over 750 horsepower, plus bucket seats. Needed bucket seats, presumably. Say all cabs should have wide bodies and flared arches. Think about it. More stability, more speed, more downforce, more room for your terrified passengers. Slick tyres for maximum grip on a bone-dry drag strip. So they should be interesting when we hit the beach. I'd say we're nicely warmed up for the next bit. So here we are then. In the old days, daredevils used smooth, sandy beaches like this to see how fast their cars could go. Many early land speed records were set on beaches. Miles of space, nothing to hit. Sounds easy, right? Oh, look at that! Laying some pretty squirmy tracks there, Stiggy. That's what happens with 750 horsepower on sand. But that's the challenge here. Go as fast as possible all the way to the top of the beach. The thing is, there's something I haven't told the Stig. Record rules say you must do two runs, one in each direction, before the clock runs out. Which means, Stiggy, pulling off the world's swiftest U-turn, which of course is when the handbrake comes in handy. from the stick there. Minicab, maximum speed. Next time I need a ride to the airport, I know who I'm calling. And all of this off-road action has given me an idea. This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here, though. Mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain. Lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction. Or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south. The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch by any means necessary and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres. Says you need an SUV to go off-road. The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. Ancient burial mounds, for example. Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back. It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds. To the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down. That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon. home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the Intrepid Explorer could ever need. Good job the roof rack holds two cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water. Final stretch now, just the small matter of getting up Arthur's seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy. That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension. The top of Arthur's seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around. Now, I said we'd be driving some British classics, and you don't get more British than a car built in Birmingham designed by a man from Greece. Anyway, here it is, an original Mini Cooper S, an icon of 60s engineering. It was designed for cities, but this is the wide-body one, so we're going to need a bit more room. And I know just the place. Ready, Stig? The Mini is cleverly packaged, capable of carrying four people and their luggage. And luggage, presumably. The Cooper S was the car to beat on the famous Monte Carlo rally. It pretty much wiped the floor with the competition. See, I am Wonder Mike, and I like to say hello. I'm to the black, to the white, the red, and the brown, and yellow. But first, I got bang, bang. The boogie to the boogie, say up, jump the boogie to the bang, bang, will you just rock? You just stop, rock the wheel, and I'll make your body rock. The Cooper S was developed by a bloke called John Cooper, who also built F1 cars, so it had real racing pedigree.
Check it out, I'm Elf the Dimp. The ladies, the women fight for my delight, but I'm the grand master with the three MCs that shop your house for the young ladies. And when you come inside, and to the front, and do the... together when the sucker MCs try to prove a point they took a field.
And it wasn't just Monte Carlo either. The British Saloon Car Championship, the Thousand Lakes Rally, even the Australian Touring Car Championship. Almost any time the Mini turned up, it won.
So they can't resist everybody. I say it goes like this when I was coming on late for dark afternoon. The reporter stopped me for an interview. She said she's her story and she's her faithful. That ambition's on the mic. And the turntable is young reporter. I did adore. So I rocked it to the time like I never did before. She said, by God, I'm in love with you. Casting over legend must have been true. I said, by the way, baby, what's your name?
So and here we are. No, it's told you, you spacious.
You surely can. Just let me quit.
We've got everything we need here. An airfield, the original rapid runabout, and the stick. I'm looking forward to this. Look at that, laying down some rubber there. Not that it has much to lay. After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tyres. Just showing off. What is it with minis and shipping containers? They sold nearly 5.5 million minis. But only this one could fly, apparently. Lovely work there. Short wheelbase, front wheel drive. It's really not an easy car to slide, this. Unstoppable. Forget rallying. This thing was made for demolition derbies. We're done now. It's time for a spot of sightseeing. Here we are then, Edinburgh, where it's time for a spot of turbocharged tourism with this, the mighty Porsche GT2 RS. All we need now is our tour guide, McStig, the world's worst Scotsman, allergic to tartan, absolutely petrified of bagpipes, or so I've heard. Right, let's see if we can visit every bell tower in Edinburgh and get back here before they all stop ringing. Is 3.8-litre flat-six, two-turbo, 700 horsepower, all wrapped up in carbon fibre with wings, stripes, holes and vents for snorting in the air. trippy little thing, isn't it? 0 to 60 takes 2.7 seconds. Just the job for a bit of speedy sightseeing. But it's only a pair of fireproof underpants away from being a full-blown racing car. It's a real masterpiece of engineering, this GT2 RS. The wheels are made from magnesium, the exhaust is titanium. It's exotic, savage, and utterly bonkers. I love it! Excellent hooliganry. That's what 700 horsepower and rear-wheel drive will do for you, if you have the guts for it, and an effective laundry detergent. Limited to 211 miles an hour, any faster and it would need special tyres. But with the stick behind the wheel, who knows? Ooh, inch perfect there. It's wider than a regular 911, this GT2, and about 20 times more terrifying. Basically, the perfect device for nipping in and out of city traffic. Final stretch now. Note to stick, remember to park properly at the end. And watch out for traffic wardens. Good work. Hard on those carbon ceramic brakes now. They can stop a locomotive dead in its tracks. I told you we'd finish with a fan's favourite, and here it is. No, not the lorry. The thing on the back, under the tarp. You'll love it. But first, we need to move it into position. Thankfully, we have our very own haulage expert, a trucker's trucker. No load too large. Yes, it's Big Rig Stig. Right, now take it easy, Stig. That's some expensive cargo you have back there. Costs as much as a house, and weighs about the same too. Work worked out what it is yet? Okay, here are some cryptic clues. It's all-wheel drive, but not four-wheel drive. It's a wagon, but you definitely don't need a horse to pull it. Five tons of flatbed carrying 4 tons on its back. Don't you just hate getting stuck behind a slow, lumbering old... Wait a minute, it's actually accelerating. Up a hill. I guess that's what 900 foot-pounds of torque does for you. That plus trucker stick. Almost there, just park it up and we'll whip those covers off. Good job, Big Rig Stig. Suits you, you know. Although, come to think of it, maybe pickups are more your style, especially the one we have in store. I give you the Mercedes G63 AMG 6x6. It's the ultimate off-roader, a 4-ton, 6-wheel sports utility truck. Basically, a G-Wagon with the back half of a pickup thrown in for free. Up front is a 5.5-litre twin-turbo V8. Usually it's limited to 100 miles an hour, but not this one. All of the grip. The 6x6 turns mountains into motorways. Is there anything it can't conquer? Oh, someone call air traffic control. I'm pretty sure you need a special license to fly one of these.
But just look at the wolves! They're out today! They're looking for their prey! So you better do one thing. You better put it.
It makes 536 horsepower and more than 760 newton meters of torque. With that speed limiter removed and with the stick behind the wheel, it'll do 125 miles an hour. With a bit of luck. It's tough, the 6x6. After all, it was originally made for the Australian Army. It's basically a tank with heated seats. It can wade through a meter of water, this thing. Most cars need full scuba kit at that depth. Ridiculous. How did you do that? It's 6 meters long. That's like drifting a canal boat. Top job there, tomorrow?
No, I think this thing does with Dale. Experimental diet, goat yoga, bog snorkeling.
Anyway, I've been Chris Harrison, still am, and this has been the Top Gear Horizons special. Thanks for coming. Now, let's go see what this Forts-a-thon live thing's all about.